Today is a very, very big and special day. And you know why? I'm gonna show you.
All this stuff right here, I'm taking out into the woods tonight because I'm gonna be staying out there by myself. And it's gonna be great. And you guys are coming along for the ride. Let's go.
I changed my clothes because, you know, I don't want to ruin the clothes that I was wearing. It has begun. We are going deep out into the woods. I'm following a trail right now, and then I'm going to go off trail. So I'll show you guys what I've been getting ready. So I'm out here in the woods right now, and I've been cutting firewood and gathering stones for this little campsite. And I'm pretty far back in the woods, as you can see. So it's going to be fun, and it's going to be fun. I'm actually right next to a little creek. See a little creek? Isn't that cool?
We're almost to the campsite, but look at this place. Check that out. And then you've got like this big like field, the trees and stuff. I love it. This place right here, me and my friends, we come here like every Saturday night and we do a campfire night right here. But we're not stopping here tonight. We're going deeper into the woods because we ain't deep enough. All right, so I've reached the campsite. I got my stuff here, and this is where I'm gonna put the tent. You can see though that I'm already starting to lose the daylight. And let me tell you guys something. I streamed before coming out here, and I knew that when I came out here, I wouldn't have that much daylight. So I gotta work quick. I gotta get this tent up. I gotta get more firewood, and we gotta be quick. So let's do it. All right, this tent is officially set up, but there's still a lot to do. So it's still busy, man. It's busy and it's hot. Look at this guy. He's right next to my campsite. He looks awesome. I like it. So one thing that I tend to do whenever I go out camping, and not everybody does this, but one of the first things I do after I get everything set up is I make a spear. Now the reason why is just, you know, just in case. I know there are coyotes out here. I know there's a lot of them. I know they're not gonna bother me, but you never know. So I'm gonna go make a spear, and while I do that, I'm gonna get firewood. I was always told when it comes to gathering firewood that get as much as you think that you need and get three times that amount. So once you're like, oh, okay, I think that's enough, go overboard because you're probably gonna need it. So I need to process this stuff and I'll be ready for tonight. I also got my spear right here. I need to obviously, you know, fix it, but that's my spear for tonight. Everything's looking good. I don't know how hot it is out here right now, but it is hot. It is very hot. Whew. It's a lot to do, but it's fun. I like it. It's good exercise. Now that's a spear. So if some critter wants to say hello to me, I got something to defend myself. I just gotta take off all this crap now and it'll be perfect. Now I'm not trying to make like a permanent weapon that like I'm gonna, you know, constantly use, but just something for tonight. Look at that. It's actually perfect because it's nice and smooth back here. So you can do a nice, good thrust. So, it's a nice spear. I'm actually gonna cut down this tree right here. Not that one, this one. And you guys will see why later tonight. So, I can officially say that camp is set up. You can see that I've got my firewood right here. It's all ready to go. You might not think that's a lot, but I'm not really gonna be making that big of a fire because I don't need it. It's not like it's freezing cold out here. The tent is all set up, the spear is made. I'm gonna use this as a little sitting seat, and I've got my little cedar wood piece right there, and I'll show you guys what I'm gonna do with that in a little bit. So, some of you guys might be wondering, you know, why? You know, why go out in the woods? Why stay out here by yourself? Are you scared? All that crap. Not scared, not at all. The reason why I love going out in the woods and the reason why I love camping by myself is because if you really want to get away from like stress and whatever it is you're dealing with, whether it's work or relationships or whatever, go out here. Go out to the woods because there is nothing out here but you and all the critters that wanna, you know, bite you and kill you. But that's the best part. that's what makes it fun. You know, it's a little dangerous, but you feel free out here. There's no stress out here, and I love it. So much air. Woo.
Something I didn't show you guys is I've got a little tinder patch right here, which I collected yesterday, and I left it drying for about 24 hours. So that should be all set and ready to go up. And then I also got some twigs here. I'm gonna get more, but the sun is starting to disappear over there, so it's almost time to start this campfire. Remember to always start with really small twigs. Don't do big ones. And when I say small, I mean like this. It should be thinner than a pencil. And then after that, you can just keep working your way up. And that's how it works. You just want to make sure that when you do start the fire, you want to have enough twigs and sticks that it'll keep going so that you can transition into all this big stuff, you know? Well, it's official. We have a fire. I'm gonna feed it a little bit, and then I am going to make me some dinner because I am hungry. We're gonna make some tea now. We're gonna boil this water in here, and then we're gonna use this as my tea. Lots of vitamin C. It's gonna be good, and I'll let you guys know how it tastes. It's actually a really, really good drink, especially, you know, at night. I know it might not look like it's getting that dark out here, but the ISO of the camera is turning up, so it's getting dark. I mean, it's not dark, but it's getting there. Now then, while we wait for this thing to boil, I'm gonna make dinner. And these are on the menu. Some wieners, nothing better. Check that out. Coolest thing you've ever seen, right? I think so. Yeah. All right, I've got this glove here, so I'm gonna take the tea off. We got this amazing rock right here too. It's kind of like a little table. And I'm just gonna let these wiener dogs cook for about, I don't know, 20 minutes. And we'll see how they taste. You hear that? Listen to that. Oh yeah. Do you hear it sizzling? Man, that sounds so good. I cannot wait. And they look really good too. I want them like nice and brown though. I like them brown, but that's just me. All right, it's time to try it out. Wow, I got that perfect, like perfect. I don't have any ketchup or anything out here, just the meat and the bread, but that's all right. And I've got breakfast for in the morning. I've got some rice, so. Oh. I'm sure you guys are wondering how the tea tastes now. So. It's good. You know, has a nice piney taste to it. So it's officially dark out here right now. I can hear the owls moving around and the dogs barking in the distance, and I can hear bats. You guys can probably hear them too. And so far it's pretty nice. I got the little fire going right there. I'm gonna make it a little bit bigger. I'm gonna chill out by it. And now that I've eaten, I think I'll just, I don't know, sing some songs and have a smoke. If you guys are curious how the campsite looks at night, well, here you go. It's really nice, like the way that the firelight is just kind of lighting up this area. It looks really cool. I like it. There's all these damn beetles everywhere though. They're annoying me. Here's a survival tip for you guys. Find a piece of wood that clearly a bunch of termites have been eating recently. Burn it, because termite poop, when it burns, it creates a smoke and it keeps away mosquitoes. And right now, even though I'm right next to that body of water, I am not getting bit by any mosquitoes. I got bit by some earlier, but the bites are already faded and I'm not getting bitten by any anymore. So yes, find wood that's being eaten by termites. Burn it. Do it.
My name it is Sam Hall, and I robbed both rich and small, and me neck must pay for all. When I die, when I die, and my neck must pay for all. When I die.
It's a very, very special occasion, and so that means you gotta smoke a pipe. I'm gonna use this little stick right here as my pipe tool. For those of you that don't smoke pipes, one thing that pipe smoking does for you is it creates a very, like, I describe it as like a zen feeling, very zen feel, because you're not inhaling the smoke, you're just tasting it. And so you're not really getting that, like, nicotine rush, like if you were, like, smoking cigarettes or something. So it's just really, like, it just makes you feel calm, you know? It doesn't make you feel high or dizzy or anything. You're just calm, chill. It's kind of like how you feel, like, maybe after, like, you work out and you're just kind of sitting down and you're just, like, and you're just relaxing. You feel, like, you just kind of feel chill, you know? I don't know how to describe it. You just feel very chill.
Once a jolly swagman camped by a billabong under the shade of the coolibah tree. It's a working man I am, and I've been down underground, and I swear to God if I ever see the sun.
So I've had my first visitor of the night. It's to be expected. I'm just laying here reading, and I could hear something right here just kind of walk up. It didn't sound very big, probably like, I don't know, like a rabbit or something, something of that size, maybe a raccoon, maybe, but clearly came out to check out the campsite. He gave a little psh on the tent, and pew, he went flying. So whatever he was, he's gone now, and he ain't coming back. That's right. All right, so I'm done reading. It's been a little while. I got the campfire going again. And I told you guys that I was going to do something with this piece of wood, and I cut it down for a reason, or chopped it up for a reason, and that is, I am going to do a little bit of wood whittling. I don't know if you guys knew this, but I actually do a lot of wood whittling. Well, not a lot, but I do a little bit. And so I'm just going to whittle some wood in my free time. You guys aren't going to be able to see anything because it's dark. So it's about 10 o'clock at night right now, I think. Last time I checked my phone, it was like 9:40 something. I did a little bit of wood whittling, not too much because it is dark, so I can't really see what I'm doing, but I think I'm gonna retreat into the tent and I'm gonna read a bit more, and yeah, and then I'll eventually go to bed. So I'm just gonna let this fire kind of die out, and in the morning I'll make some breakfast. Sound good? Sounds good. I cannot begin to describe to you guys, and only those of you that, like, go camping by yourselves know this feel. It's so comfy, because it's like you have all this woodland, all this whatever, but, like, right here, this is, like, right here, in this little, like, you know, 6x6 space, you have civilization, and it's nice. There was something out there. There's actually an ant on my phone, you son of a bitch. I think it was like a duck or something. It was just making like these noises out in the darkness. But it was kind of cute. I liked it.
Alright, so it's about 11 o'clock at night right now. I've got a big-ass root in my back. Feels good. And I have one more challenge, and that's to construct some form of pillow, because I forgot to bring a pillow. And that's it. I guess I'll see you guys in the morning. See ya. So, right now, I can't tell you at all what time it is, because my phone is 100% dead. I've just been, like, sleeping in small bursts. Like, I've just been, you know, sleep for an hour, wake up, sleep for another hour, wake up. So, this is probably, like, the fifth time that I've woken up. The spot that I'm camping on right now has a couple of, like, roots that you can't really see because they're concealed by the grasses, but you can feel them once you lay down. So I've been kind of struggling, moving around the tent, trying to find a comfortable spot. And, oh man, let me tell you, I am beating myself up for forgetting that pillow, because sleeping on that log is a pain in the ass. Did I show you guys what I'm sleeping on? Like, let me show you what I'm sleeping on. I've got this BlizzCon bag right here, and then the foundation of my pillow is, well, hold on, is this. I'm sleeping on the the piece of wood that I was using for carving. See that? So, this is my pillow right here. This is what I've been using. Uncomfortable does not even describe it, but that's okay. It is really relaxing, though, you know, being out here. It's nice and quiet. Gives you time to think and just kind of chill out. But, you know, normally these hours that I'm awake right now, or well, like around this time, this is when I'm usually awake and I'm working on videos. So my internal clock is like all screwed up. It's like, wait, hold on. Like you're supposed to be awake right now working, and I've been trying to sleep. So I think I'm just gonna like read for a little bit and deal with this like annoying little happy fly you guys can probably hear up there buzzing around. So, yeah. Hey guys, so again, I can't tell you what time it is, but I just woke up, and I mean, it probably still looks kind of dark on the GoPro, because GoPros are pretty bad with lighting, but the sun is coming up. You can probably hear all the birds. They've come out, they're singing. And so I'm actually going to go out there and I'm going to get the fire going again, and I'm going to, I guess, make myself something to eat. I'll tell you guys one thing, man. Whenever you have a really long night while camping, for whatever reason, as soon as you start seeing the sun come up, it's just so... The sun has such a... It has such a presence to it. I can't really describe it, but you really appreciate it. All right, so I've got my tinder bundle, and I've got my little handful of sticks. So I am ready to go and light this thing up. So let's try it. Fire started, it looks good, and now it is time to get some breakfast ready. I've got some rice here, got my little bowl, and I've got some water. So I'm gonna be making rice for breakfast, and it's gonna be good. I'm actually gonna mess with the fire a little bit so I can put this up on top of it so it heats up a little faster, but it's on its way, man. All right, check that out. Water is already starting to boil. Guys, you have no idea. I am so friggin' hungry right now, so, man, I'm ready to dig into that. Let's grab it real fast, put it right there. There we go.
Look at how much firewood I still have left over from last night. I mean, check that out. Isn't that cool? I'm telling you, man, when you go camping, just be super over-prepared. That might look like ridiculously over-prepared, but that's what you gotta do, man. That's what you gotta do, because you never know what could happen. All right, guys, the campsite is all packed up. I'm ready to get out of here.
I don't really think there's anything that interesting to say walking back. So guys, thank you for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. I'm definitely gonna do more stuff like this in the future. One thing that I didn't get to do, which I really did wanna do, was I really wanted to whittle that wood a lot longer, because I didn't really get that much time to do it because it was dark and I couldn't see. So maybe for my next vlog, I'm gonna show you guys me doing some wood whittling, and I'll show you what I can do. And hopefully you guys will like what I make, but we'll find out. Either way, guys, thank you for watching. Stay tuned for more, and I will see you all on my next vlog. All right? All right.